persisted. It is the determiner of the compound syntactic stages. What I mean by this statement is, let's come to the example. Now I have made a word that this is containing the affixes of head. The word is green house. Here, the house playing the role as the head of the compound words. As you know, the compound words is two words that become one word that has a different meaning. Like here is green house. Doesn't mean that the house color is green, but it has an own meaning, which is the house of agriculture. And this is what we call as compound words. Well, the house here is the head of the word system. So this is what we mean by affixes.
Talk about multiple affixation. Multiple affixation is when a word theme is attacked by more than one affixes. There are two kinds of affixes. Here is first is prefix and second is suffix. So to make it clear what is the multiple affixation, you can see this example. Here the word have is attacked by suffix full and then become adjective full. This is cannot call multiple affixation because this is just consist of one affixes. Here, helpful plus attack by prefix become unhelpful, and then unhelpful attacks by ness, suffix ness become unhelpfulness. Here, both of them can call multiple affixation because in this word consists of more than one affixes. Here, un is prefix, and then full suffix, also ness, also affix. So, unhelpfulness we can call multiple affixes.
Consider there are two examples that I have written before. They are two hard compounds. The first is window cleaner and oven cleaner. From these two examples, can we then generate a new word which can refer to compound with compound like window oven cleaner? Probably yes, but it doesn't necessarily mean something that completes both window and oven. But rather, it refers to something that includes oven that has a see-through panel. So, from these examples, we know that certain compounds would generate a different meaning if we put together the words.
Now we're going to move to apparent matches with the new instructor. When we make a phrase or a sentence, maybe perhaps, we sometimes find it difficult because there are mismatches between the meaning and the structure, right? So how do we find out which one is the right meaning? The answer is we use resting paradox. For example, consider a phrase and we have physicists. Which one is the right answer? Is it physicist who is a nuclear or an expert in nuclear physics? Now, if we follow the grammatical structure, it will be this one. The meaning will be physicist who is a nuclear. It doesn't make sense, right? Therefore, we use repetitive paradox. So, we write like this: nuclear physics is the affix is not attached to the word physics, but instead it's attached to the whole phrase. Therefore, the meaning will be an expert in nuclear physics. Like that.
Thank you so much for watching.